the ACMER Ascarva 4S, a newcomer in desktop CNC and possibly a great entry-level option for beginners. Today, I'll unbox it, assemble it, take a look at its special mechanical system, which is completely new to me, and then I'll test a few of its applications by making these nice-looking coasters on it. Let's get started. ACMER is already known for their quality desktop laser machines, and I'm curious to see if they manage to bring that same quality and user-friendliness into the CNC world. The Ascarva 4S is a beginner-friendly desktop CNC with a 40x40cm work area and a 70W spindle motor. ACMER provided me with this unit for testing, and I'm eager to try it and share my experience with you. If I can get a discount code before publishing, I'll link it in the description, along with a link to the machine itself. Now let's take a look inside the box. Right on top, you'll find the manual, with clear illustrations and part references. The first tray has the numbered frame components, some nice aluminium fronts with logos and guide symbols. I love the color of this. The black and orange combo on this machine gives a unique look. Then there's a ruler, a brush, and a touchscreen display, which connects with this spiral cord. Interestingly, it doesn't come with pre-drilled holes for mounting, so I'm curious to see how it attaches later. It has a USB-C input as well. The next tray includes power cables, a bag with end mills, the C probe, which connects with a 3.5mm plug. And that is a nice touch. Then clamps and screws, all in labeled bags, and the usual accessories. Computer cable, memory cards, and all the tools you'll need for assembly and maintenance. Some more foam, and I noticed some test materials. I'm not quite sure what these can be used for. If you know, tell me in the comments, please. Then we have the gantry, which comes pre-assembled, complete with even lighting already installed. You might notice something missing here. No threaded rods on the X-axis, and that's our first hint of the motion system. We'll take a closer look at that later. Next are the side pieces of the gantry. The sliding mechanism looks really smooth. The electronics box contains the motherboard, power switch, emergency stop, and all cables, pre-bundled in protective sheathing and chain links. Up front, it's got the power input, USB-C port, memory card slot, and display connector. At the back, a port for the C probe, a laser module, and even a 500W spindle upgrade port. And finally, the two MDF boards that form the work surface. With so many pre-assembled parts and simple layout, this should be a quick build. Let's put it together. Starting with the frame, everything is clearly marked, hard to go wrong here. The parts are a bit thin and light, so I do wonder about stability, but that might actually be intentional. Many machines use a threaded bar for the X and Y axis, but not this one. That's probably why it can get away with a lighter frame. Next are the side panels. They contain the Y axis drive. I'll mount the electronics box to the first front panel and the cable chain to the moving gantry support. I always like to see cable management with cable chains. You can work the machine in all directions without any trouble with connections. Now it's time to attach the sides to the frame. That is done by these brackets. When attaching the brackets to the side piece, notice the four wheels underneath. That's the motion system. Unlike many CNCs that share one central motor for the Y-axis, this one uses two motors, one on each side, to move the gantry back and forth. Attaching the gantry itself is a little tricky, since there's no way to support it when driving in the screws. But once in place, it feels solid, despite the thin cross brace. The X-axis runs on the same wheel system instead of a lead screw, so it doesn't need as much thickness either. The MDF panels add stability to the frame. Once the front panel and display bracket are attached, it's time to connect the cables. All connections are clearly labeled, and most of them run through a single cable chain. A smart way to keep things tidy. It does make for a crowded junction here. I might clean it up later with some extra sheathing once I know everything works. A few plugs on the opposite side, and then the display connects. And it's held in place with a strong magnet, which is a neat touch. You can hold it in your hand or snap it onto the frame. And that's it for assembly. Before testing, let's take a closer look at the motion system. Here's the timing belt. It runs the full length of both the X and Y axis. A pulley connected to the motor drives the belt, which moves the gantry back and forth. This makes for smoother, faster motion and allows for a lighter frame design, while still maintaining accuracy, down to 0.01 mm according to the specs. The Z axis, though, still uses the more traditional lead screw. Let's power it up and see if everything works. Sorry for the slight focus issue here, but I still wanted to show this. The touchscreen response is excellent. Some other machines I've tested had noticeable lag, but this one feels instant and precise. You can control everything directly from the screen, but for testing, I'll use easel on my computer to control the machine. The spindle, light, and motion all work perfectly. Time to make something. I mount a sacrificial MDF board to protect the bed, connect the machine to my computer, and set up everything in easel. Everything connected right away, as the machine runs on GRBL control system. For the test, I'm using a piece of hardwood with some nice grain. The surface was a little uneven, so I started with a 3mm upcut bit, clearing a 2mm pass to level it. The machine handled it easily. Next, I began cutting the inlay for my coaster project, starting with the same bit for the outline. I don't cut all the way through though, as it will be easier to trim the back off on the bandsaw later. A simple cut and the inlay will fall right out of the board. Then I switched to a 30-degree engraving bit to carve the logo. For the backing piece, I use black MDF, cutting a 4mm recess for the inlay and a 9mm outer edge. I made sure to set up the cut for the inlay inside the design edge in easel and outside of the design edge for the backplate. This will make for a snug fit. This piece is also thicker than I wanted, so I cut it down to depth and clear off the back on the bandsaw. To finish, I filled the engraved logo with colored epoxy, which I think will look great with the contrast between the hardwood and the black MDF. After curing, I sanded off the excess epoxy, did some light hand sanding on the edges, and applied some oil to both the inlay and the backplate. Then I glued the pieces together, and there you have it. A fun little project, and a nice first test on the ACMER Ascarva 4S. It worked really well, and it seems like a good beginner CNC. I especially like the touchscreen, cable management, and how lightweight and compact it is for a machine with this size work area. Thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next one.